Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Force here with a continuation of our Magic the Gathering Duels of the Planeswalkers 2013 playthrough series, hopping straight into the campaign. Couple of things before we get started here. You're gonna notice I've actually already defeated Audric and Liliana now. The last we left off, I had just played these two encounters, Face of the Ghoulcaller and Stampede. I did both of those in one video. I recorded the playthroughs of fighting these two guys, but the footage actually got corrupt, and you're gonna see the next tier. I haven't unlocked, but I haven't done any of these matches yet, so we're just gonna play through these again. I also want to let you know, from this point going forward, I'm gonna start making these videos longer. My last video was, again, two encounters. I'll probably do two matches per video. That's gonna put them between 20 and 30 minutes, most likely. Obviously, sometimes you can have quicker games, sometimes they'll be longer, but I think we'll probably try to average about two matches per video. That way these videos are a little bit longer, and you guys get a little more enjoyment out of that. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump right into the next mission, which is gonna be here against Audric. Now, I am going to play the black deck. You guys have already seen me play with the mono green pack Instinct. You've seen me play Born of Flame, the mono red, and you have seen me play with Crosswinds. So what I would like to do here is we're going to go ahead. Oh, come on, what are you doing here, you stupid? There you go. We're going to play this mono black deck. Now, people have also asked me to show these decks so that they know what's in it. I'm not going to sit here and read through every card. What are you doing? I'm not going to sit here and read through every card, but I will nevertheless show you everything. So let's go ahead and flip through this really quickly. A couple of Crippling Blights, Fume Spitter, two of those, Innocent Blood. And you can pause if you want to take the time to read these, but at the very least, I just wanted to show people the cards that were in the deck. Now this deck, a lot of life gain and life subtraction from players and enemies. There's also a few discards. We've got a decent mix of creatures, not a ton of creatures in here, but most of them are utility as well. Underworld Dreams, amazing card, really, really strong. Very good creature card there. That's kind of garbage. We'll probably get rid of that eventually. Bloodhound Bat, not terrible. It is a 2-2 flyer, which is pretty nice. Couple of Liliana Sage, Tendrils of Corruption, and again, please feel free to pause. Literally, though, if I sat here and read every card, it would take, you know, 6-7 minutes, and I don't want to spend all that time in this video, but I did at the very least want to show people the decks before we get started, and take a look at that baller creature right here. Intense casting cost of 7 mana, but it's a 6-6 flying. When it enters the battlefield, search your library for a card, put it in your hand, then shuffle your library. That's pretty awesome, of course. Aside from the fact that it's beefy flying creature, having basically a demonic tutor as well, which, if you don't know, just an amazing card that lets you search your library for any card and put it in your hand. Anything like that is amazing. It's very, very, very strong, so that's pretty cool. Again, the casting cost is a little bit ridiculous. Makes it so that chances are, in most decks, you wouldn't see more than two or three of these. Even that's kind of pushing it. You definitely wouldn't see four just because it costs so much. I guess unless you had an acceleration deck of sorts. But there you go. Again, just showing off the deck that we're going to be using here. Let's go ahead and get things started. Now we are against a white weenie deck in Audric. Let's see what we can do against that, shall we, my friends? Yes, let's see indeed. Take a look at the hand. 3 mana. First hand. Blister Beetle. 1/1 when it comes into play. Target creature gets -1/-1. Obviously solid. Not the greatest, just a 3/2 creature. Vileborn Ghoul, 4/1. Can't block. However, whenever a swamp enters the battlefield under your control, you may return Vileborn Ghoul from your graveyard to your hand. So pretty much guarantees if it gets in the graveyard, it'll eventually get back in your hand. All you gotta do is play a land. And we drew into Rune Scar Demon. That's not the best first turn card to have in your hand, because again, you can't play it for a very long time. But this hand isn't awful, so I'm just going to go ahead and keep it. And we are playing first, so let's drop the swamp and then say go to Mr. Audric. Let's see if he has anything first turn. Audric, no, you do not. Now, second turn, I can play this, but I'm going to wait. I want to see if he plays anything next turn, and then I drop this, give it -1/-1, and chances are it'll die unless it's a 1/2. But we'll see. So I'm just going to skip playing him this turn for that reason. I'd rather use him to have that drop actually do something, you know, rather than just putting a 1/1 creature into play. I mean, the entire point of having that card in your deck is to pop a creature off the battlefield. So let's see what he plays right here. He plays a 3/1. Cha-ching! Look at that. So he plays a quarter paladin. It's a 3-1 with Battlecry, meaning when he attacks, all of their creatures that are also attacking get plus 1 to their attack. And I can actually, I believe, show you that with F1. There it is. So all of their attacking creatures get plus 1 power for the rest of the turn. So that's a strong card, but again, since I held on to Blister Beetle, I'm going to play him this turn and then just get that guy off the battlefield. He's going to get -1/-1, and once he drops down to 0 defense, he dies. So, here it is. Blister Beetle goes into play. Target creature gets -1/-1. It's, of course, going to be him. And then we say, Audric, sorry, but goodbye. There you go. Chances are he'll be playing another creature this turn. He is playing a white weenie deck, which is, you know, filled with lots of low casting cost creatures, some good utility, some good synergy in this deck as well. 2-1, First Strike Vigilance. So, very strong card as well. First Strike means he hits first in any combat between two creatures. Vigilance also means he doesn't tap when he attacks. So, I can't, unfortunately, right now attack with my 3-2 because this guy will actually kill him because of that First Strike. And then my guy won't actually do any damage. He'll die before any damage can resolve. So, that's something that it's unfortunate. And let's go ahead and take a look at what I drew into. So we have those bats and we know about their 2-2 flying. That's something I can do. This is 2 damage to our creature and I gain 2 life. We could just do that right now. And... Or I could... How should I do this? I might just hold on to him for now. Actually, you know what? This guy even has vigilance, so even when he attacks, he's not going to... This is just 2 damage to target player, not to a creature. So let's do this. I'm going to last kiss him, hit him with 2 damage, and then I gain 2 life. But now I can also swing, because he would have blocked, and none of it would have gone through, and this guy would have died. So we swing for 1 now, bring him down to 19. I'm at 22. Still, you know, anyone's game at this point, though. I've had a pretty strong opening, wiped his creatures twice already, but here we go. We're gonna expect this to keep coming. All right, Crusader of Audric. It's a star. It has power and toughness equal to the number of creatures that he controls. So right now it's just a 1-1. Not too scary. But it, of course, can get pretty big pretty quick. We got 5 in play now. Now we could play the 4-1. We could play the 2-2 flying. We could play the 3-2. 4-1 sounds good to me. I can hold off on this the 2-2 flying for now. Let's go ahead and put him into play. And I'm going to, this attack phase, I'm going to swing with my 1-1. Now, he shouldn't block here. He should just hold on to this creature so that he keeps getting bigger. There really should be no question about that. There it is. He takes the 1. Bring him down to 18. Alright, now, gonna start to get a little worried with this guy once he starts throwing more into play. Let's see, 3-1-1 tokens, and already, there you have it. So he's gonna get 3-1-1 tokens into play, and that is gonna make this guy a 4-4. Let's see if he decides to attack with it. If he does, I'm gonna just chump block it, yeah. So I'm not gonna take that 4 damage, no way in hell. We're gonna go ahead and block. What? Can't block. I'm a dope. Didn't even read that. Oh, I'm an idiot. So he hits for 4 and I can do nothing about it. I'm feeling pretty silly right now, guys. What to do? Yeah, we can get both these guys in play. It's a 3-2 again. Alright, gonna go with this here. Gonna play the Warpath Ghoul. And also play the Fume Spitter. Alright, so... I can't block with him, so I might as well attack. And you're gonna say that's suicide, he's just gonna block. The good thing, though, is that if he does block, he's going to lose this. This is going to drop this down to a 3-3, which will be a little bit more manageable for me. I also got some plans to do some sacrifice in action and stuff as well. So let's go ahead and just attack with him for now. I'm gonna chill out with this guy. Attack with the 4-1. Let's see if he blocks. He's going to block now. Okay. It's gonna be a bunch of creature trading here. Now again, remember, even though this guy died, I dropped him down to a 3-3 for now. Now chances are really high he's going to play a creature right now though. Oh. Starting off with Ring of Thune. It's a artifact equipment. Equipped creature has vigilance, does not tap when it attacks, and at the beginning of your upkeep, put a 1-1 counter on equipped creature if it's white. Obviously all of his creatures are white, so he's gonna put that right on this guy, no question about that. First he's gonna play another one. Oh boy. Things are getting a little scary here. It's going straight on him, right? Yeah, there it is. All right, he didn't attack either. So, let's take a look at this. This is nice. Well, I can sacrifice this to put a -1/-1 counter on a creature. Thinking of attacking with him. Okay, ready? You guys ready for this? This is what's going to go down right now. Let's see if this works in my favor. This could go horribly wrong. All right, here's my game plan. Let's do this. I attack with both of these. Just bear with me here, all right? Let's see if he blocks. Okay. All right, so. So he's going to block that, and he takes 1 damage. Now. Put this into play. Give him -1/-1. Sacrifice him. Give him -1/-1. Goodbye. That got rid of a huge threat. This guy was going to start getting gigantic very soon. And that whole trade-off there was well worth it to me, in my opinion. Some of you may be watching this and say, Force, that wasn't the best move in the world that you could have made. Maybe that's true, but I'm happy with it. Tell you what. Now, if he attacks with both these guys, I am going to block one. He's got those enhancements on them. Here's a 2-2 lifelink. When it dies, put a 1-1 white creature token with flying onto the battlefield. Okay, so it's a 2-2 lifelink. It's got a nice little ability when it dies as well. It's still anyone's game. All right, he's going to attack with both of these. It is no question in my mind that I block one. Remember, he put those enhancements on them. They're going to start getting pretty big. So I obviously got to go ahead and block. There. Get rid of that guy. I'll take that one. I'm okay so far with trading my creatures with him, you know? I'm still ahead of him in life total right now. So, and also, there we go, I just played, so you see what happened, I just played a swamp and that immediately brought him back to my hand whenever I play a swamp, from graveyard to hand. I've got 6 in play. Another good thing to keep in mind is this guy's coming out very shortly. All I have to do is draw into another swamp and we are ready to rock. So from this point, I think this is going to be my next move here. Put the bat into play. Okay. Bat's in play. He loses 2 life. I gain 2 life. Sounds good to me. And then I've got the 3-2, which we can just attack with. And I will. Swing for 3. Let's see if he blocks with the 2-2. Wouldn't be totally surprised. Okay. So he blocks with the 2-2. Now he gained 2 life from the lifelink and he got a 1-1 flying in play, but I'm okay with the 1-1 flying, and that also got the 2-2 lifelink out of play. If he kept attacking me and I kept taking damage, he would keep gaining life, and that just whole situation back and forth could be pretty annoying. I'm still comfortable with trading creatures with him. Oblivion Ring. Alright, ready for this? When Oblivion Ring enters the battlefield, exile another target non-land permanent. When Oblivion Ring leaves the battlefield, return the exiled card to the battlefield. So it's just he exiles a creature. Oblivion Ring's awesome. He's gonna get rid of my 2-2 flying. That's what's about to happen. So that's exiled. I'm taking 3 damage here. Nothing I can do about it. There it is. Down to 16. He's got 1 card in hand. Nothing, though. All right, so here it is, guys. Now it is time. Runescarred Demon. 6/6 flying comes into play. Search my library for a card. Put it into my hand. This is a beautiful, glorious card to have. And there it is. Now in play. I'm sure he wished he would have saved his Oblivion Ring for that, huh? All right, so time to figure out what we want here. Got all sorts of options. Number of swamps I control to target creature or player. I gain life for that, which is good. 3/6 death touch. Put a petrification counter on target creature. It gains defender and becomes a colorless artifact in addition to its other types. Its activated abilities can't be activated. So, what this does is it turns one of his creatures into a wall, and that's it. Can't attack, can't do nothing. It also has death touch, meaning whenever, I'll show you exact wording here, creatures dealt damage by something with death touch are destroyed. So if this creature does damage to anything, it destroys it. Again, I can put a petrification counter on something, turn it, give it defender, which means creature with defenders can't attack. So I can turn any of his offensive creatures into walls, which can't do anything. That is awesome, of course. I'm sorry, let me keep going through here. I'm probably going to pick her. I just want to take a quick look here. Rise from the Grave, not bad, of course. Underworld Dreams, wouldn't it be awful? Where was I? There it is. Underworld Dreams will not be bad to have. Whenever he draws a card, he loses a life. I think it's almost a no-brainer there to go with her, but I just want to quickly filter through again. Yeah, we're going to have to go with her, aren't we? Where'd she go? There she is. That's the one. So next turn, she's coming into play. And then that'll pretty much be it. He just played the last card in his hand. He's at 0 cards. Gets him 2/1/1 creatures into play. Congratulations, dude. Good for you. So, looks like I just won the game. Unless he gets something incredible this turn. These creatures are getting bigger. That's fine. I'm going to nullify them shortly enough. Not attacking, as he shouldn't. I have a 6/6 in play. He would guaranteed lose some of what he has. This is pretty nice, but that'll wait, because first thing is first, we play this glorious creature. So it's a 3/6 death touch right now. I can also put this into play. Give enchanted creature -1/-1. Yeah, we'll just go ahead and put it on one of these guys, just kill it. And then we say go. Should I? Yeah, maybe I should just swing. Yeah, why not? He's not going to win. Attacking for 6. Expect him to probably block with the 2/2. Is he really going to take this? Ooh! Painful. He didn't want to block because he wanted it to get bigger. But I don't know, man. I don't know if that was the best decision there by Audric. So he hits me for 3 flying, which I can't block right now. She does not have flying. I take that. That's fine. Brings me down to 13. He's still got a card in hand, which he should certainly be able to play. That was weird. Why did he do that? He just switched the enhancements from one to the other. Oblivion Ring. Ouch. Of course that happens, right? So he's getting rid of my 3/6. That is too bad. Oh, whoa, really? Huh. Weird. Weird that he did it that way. Really weird. Liliana Shade enters the battlefield. Search the library for a swamp card. Reveal it. Put it in your hand. Okay, so now the first thing I'm going to do is we're going to go ahead and do this. Petrification counter on a creature. Gains defender. Becomes a colorless artifact. Yada, yada, yada. We're going to go ahead and put this on the 4/4. or the flying. I'm not gonna die next turn. Let's just put it on the 4/4 for now. I can keep doing this every turn. I'm just gonna keep turning his creatures into stupid walls. and we're also gonna put the shade into play just because. Get a creature in play. Now he's gonna be able to hit me next turn for four. This is going to be a 4/4 flying. And it probably hit me with the 1/1 as well. I wouldn't be too surprised. Go ahead and put this into play. He might not want to attack with the 1/1 though, because I can block it, pump him up, and kill it. Nevertheless though. So this guy can't attack anymore. It was stupid of him not to pick that. I don't know. I'm just saying. I guess the 6/6 flying was obviously a major threat, but. So he's going to hit me for 4 now, and that puts me down to 9. The problem is that I'm just going to petrify this guy now. So, that's that. Destroy target creature as well. Yeah, we're looking good here. Let me do this then, actually. Let me destroy his 4/4. 4/4 flying is gone. Let us put a petrification counter on the 1/1, and now he's got two creatures that can't attack. They can block, though, which means swinging with this 1/1 right now isn't going to work. So we're not going to do it. All right, Captain's Call. 3/1/1 tokens into play. This game is going, huh? This game is just keeps going, man. He's gonna switch one of these over. He's gonna activate that as well. He should. There we go. Still hoping to top deck something. This is a little precarious here. What are you doing now, Audric? Do something. Or let me go. Thank you. Alright. Chanted creature gets -1/-1. So, we'll put that on one of these guys. I will then go ahead and play the ghoul. Which means, unfortunately, though, I can't petrify this turn. And I'm actually going to attack this turn with the 3/6. He could kill it though. So I'm not going to do that. Yeah, not going to attack this turn. All right, all is not lost, my friends, don't worry. Nail biter. All right, he chose not to attack. He's going to put some more stuff on his wall. Oh, Glorious Anthem. All his creatures get +1/+1. That's an enchantment. Stays in play for good. Nothing I can do about enchantments, unfortunately. What do we draw into? Anything. Each player sacrifices a creature. Is that worth it for me? I need to start getting a flying creature, else I'm not even going to be able to hit him. I can attack with this, though, and pump him up a ton. Let me do that before anything else. And, attacking with him isn't going to really work. Because he'll just block with a 5/5 wall. Let's see. Let me attack with the 1/1. Let's see what he does. Blocking with the 2/2. So what I do at this point then, is that all he's blocking with? Yes. So just pump it up. 2/3. Pump it up twice. Makes it a 3/3. Kill his creature. Mine's still alive. And then, gonna go ahead and petrification counter on him this time. And I don't think I want to do Innocent Blood at the moment, because he'll just sacrifice his 2-2 and whatever. So we'll just hold on to that for now. This is the longest game we've had so far, huh? Wow. Audric, man, oh man. What are you doing to me here? He can attack with his 2-2. Which he should do. Bring me down to 7. And he does still have a card in hand, unfortunately. He's gonna move that over to the 2-2. Why did he not do that before he attacked? Weird. Alright. Pacifism means that my 3-6 cannot attack or block. However, it doesn't say I can't use activated abilities, so I can still go ahead and use her abilities. Which is a good thing. Enters the battlefield, each opponent discards a card. Well, he's got no cards in hand. But it's still a 2-1 flying, and flying's exactly what I need right now. So that's going in play. Also, I need to do this. Turn that into a wall. And then that's it. I don't want to attack with this 1-1. I can pump him up twice, but he can block with a 5-5. I think I'm going to have to try to get the win with the 2-1 flying. I think that's exactly what's going to have to happen. And no point still in me attacking with a 4-1, because again, he just blocks with a 5-5, and that's it. Alright, so, we go. Audric gets another turn. Go ahead, bud. It's all you. What are you drawing to, huh? What is it this time, Audric? What do you got? He's moving around his enchantments. It's really not doing much for him. What did you draw into? Stop just moving around your enchantments. Doing nothing. Just wasting mana. Oh, this is so annoying. What is he doing? Unbelievable. Plays 3. 2-2 first strike. When it enters the battlefield, put a 1-1. White soldier token into the battlefield. Not too concerned about that. Not too worried about that. Do this right away. That guy. And then, finally, get to attack this turn and actually do something with this. These two going through. He can't block the flying. He can block the 1-1, but I will pump it up. He's gonna block it with a 2-2, so I just need to pump him up twice. Make it a 3-3. He takes 2. Now he can attack me with a 2-2, which I can't block. I cannot block it. But that'll just bring me down to 5. And the next turn that gets pacified. Audric, you have given me the hardest time. Out of anyone so far. And now he's gonna move around his enhancement a million times. Which does nothing for him. Hits for 2. Brings me down to 5. Looks like we do have this, unless he draws into something that completely trumps what I've got going on here. Alright, Audric. Yeah, move it around another 6 times. Go ahead. Please. Be my guest. Another shade, which is really awesome, to be honest with you. First things first. Petrification counter on him. So he's a wall. And then, next I want to attack these guys here. See what he does. All right, so he's blocking for 5, 6, 7, 8. Unfortunately, actually, that is going to trump him. Now, what I will do, though, I'm going to pump him up twice to make him a 3-3, and hopefully it hits that guy, but he's got first strike. Shoot. Should I make it a 4-4 then? And then I won't be able to play him. Well, that didn't exactly... I didn't fully think that through. You know what? Let's do this. Unfortunately, I think it's going to assign the damage automatically, though. Tap 6 to pump him up to a 7-7. I will die, though. Why are you doing damage that way? That annoys me. Oh, well, the 5-5 died, though, which is good. Now, he can't attack me right now. He's got nothing to attack with. They're all walls. So, again, I think I've got this game, unless he gets a trump card here. 2-2 first strike comes into play. Put a 1-1 token into play. Another one of those pains in the butt. And he's going to move these over, obviously. Now I'm going to pacify the 3-3 first strike again. What are we drawing to here? Deals damage equal to the number of swamps you control to target creature or player. You gain life equal to the damage dealt this way. Alright, ready? Corrupt. Player. I win. Drew into the win. I still had the game, but that was longer and closer than I really had hoped it would have been. That was actually a pretty intense, pretty long drawn out game. Thanks for watching, guys. Again, I know I said I was going to start putting two of these together, but that was longer than I thought. I probably want to keep these videos around 15 to 25 minutes or so. So with that game being a little drawn out, that's going to cut it for this one. We'll go ahead and get the next play here against Liliana right after this. So thank you guys so much for watching. Tune into the next video. And of course, as always, if you like the content, please subscribe. Thanks again, guys. Keep watching and keep owning.